pitch or the different pitch. Okay, so at the same pitch do this, different pitch do this. Some people call it the melodic contour. Okay, but contour is a very big word that you can use. What's the melodic shape? So just now what I'm doing is just two pitches. Okay? And then you're able to tell is it higher or lower, same, is it going up or down. Okay? How if it's a melody? What is the shape of your melody? Okay, so the shape of your melody, with or without a score, you should be able to tell. Okay? Of course, with a score, it's easier to tell the shape of the melody. You can see in your piano score also, you can see the melody, is it ascending, descending, is it stagnant? Okay, but without the score, okay, what is the melodic shape? Okay, so later when you look at one or two exercises, okay, I want you to first think about the melodic shape. That will help you think of how you want to sing it. How can you actually sing it accurately? Okay? Let's take a very simple song, Happy Birthday. Right? Everybody knows the song Happy Birthday. What is the melodic shape of Happy Birthday? You have paper with
you.
Yeah,
after you read your book.
Okay, anything else? I want you to draw.
You all can use the back of the program sheet.
Yeah, just a very tiny space is enough. Can I use the ball?
Oh, I'll borrow your program sheet. You want to use?
Okay, if y'all want to know what I'm talking about, can y'all look here? It's very like weird looking counter here. Okay, and sometimes I'm going to sing la 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 la. This is how I draw. La 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 la. Okay, if you think happy birthday, if you think that the melody is the same, okay, then you draw same. If you think it's ascending, descending, here, what is the shape of happy birthday? Okay, there's no right or wrong answer. Well, not everybody's shape will look the same. Okay, so you try to figure it out. The shape will look the same. But we should be going in a similar direction.
Happy birthday.
Mm-hmm. Everybody know happy birthday, I know you.
The first sentence.
The whole song.
The whole song,
yeah.
The whole song.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. See that the last leap is obviously the biggest.
Yes.
Right? And I can see that there's already a leap there. It's even a larger D. Okay, so descending.
So, we should see the third sentence like the biggest D.
Okay, so that is just a little simple activity for you. Of course, you can, if you really want to go by every single note, then it will look a little bit like yours.
Because it's not in my time.
You want to show it your friends? No,
it's actually an octave.
You're in the hospital and the heart rate. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, but what is the overall shape of the music? Okay, think that matters more. Okay, the direction of where the music is going. Where are the biggest leaves? Are there a smaller leaf followed by a bigger leaf? Is the melody actually ascending or descending? Yeah, okay? So you can do this simple exercise for any piece of music that you have that you can sing or play on the piano. You're able to kind of chart out the direction of the music. Alright? Okay. Then the next thing, okay, so this is melodic shape. So the first thing that we did was being able to hear pitches, right? Same pitch, different pitch. Pitch going up, pitch going down. This is about melodic control. So now we have more than one pitch, more than two pitch. We have many, many pitches in Happy Birthday, right? So how is the direction of the music? Okay? The third activity that I have is actually to train you to listen out for melody when there is an accompaniment, okay? So actually I plan for us to do a very simple singing exercise with Baby Shark. But then I don't think y'all will sing, right?
Yeah,
I think. Yeah, actually, this activity, I mean, I just tell you a little bit about it. Okay, half of you will sing the accompaniment, okay, the harmonic accompaniment. Then the other half of you will sing the melody. Okay, everybody knows Baby Shark, right? Okay, but of course, for that, we need y'all to be able to share your voices with everyone. Okay, but I think from the first activity, y'all will not really need to share your voice. Okay, so it is important that you are able to keep a melody when you have an accompaniment going, okay? Or if there is a melody and accompaniment, are you able to